Hello. So today is the first lesson on effects. So last week we spent most of it looking at the mini notation. And so you should be fairly familiar with that, or at least have a good idea about what the mini notation is and what it's for sequencing in strange ways. This week we're going to shift attention to look at how we can manipulate different aspects with a sound, still using the mini notation, but focusing on more how we can use multiple mini notation patterns together and how they're merged together. So let's go into the code magic. Right, so here is a sound, so it's picking that first sound from the CPU folder. So in a way, an effect is anything that affects a sound. It's not like a sound like boing. That's not what I mean. I mean an effect is something, some way of changing a sound. So in a way, a sound is itself an effect because the sound changes what the sound is. I think I'm talking myself in circles there. But this is what we probably are thinking about when we're thinking about effects, is this sort of thing. So it's taking that synthesized kick drum and changing it, distorting it in a strange way. So squiz would be one effect, or vowel would be another. So let's make a slightly more complicated pattern. So especially on that clap, you can hear that it's changing the sound by filtering it, so it sounds kind of like an ah vowel. So if I change that to E, you can hear the difference. So that's a nice fun thing to do. And there's loads of these, like speed will change the playback speed, so everything goes high in pitch. That can take a floating point number. There is bit crushing, so if I have quite a low number, it'll be really distorted. A higher number would be less distorted. And I'll link to the page in the user base, which has all of these effects listed so that you can explore them at your leisure. So I just want to say a little bit, I'll get into this in more depth later, but I want to say a little bit about what happens when you combine these two patterns. So if we just focus on a simple kick drum. Let's take this as an example. So we've got two kicks and then this kind of hi-hat clap pattern in the second half. So here we're just taking a single value and making it all that value. But if we want, we can just affect half of it. So if I put... So now that second half has a crush value of 16, which actually means that it's less distorted than the first half. So you can see it's kind of matching things up, like the first half has a crush value of 3, and the second half has a crush value of 16. So what's actually combining these different patterns, like the N pattern, the sound pattern, and the crush pattern, is this hash. So this is what takes two patterns and puts them together. And what this particular, there are different operators for this. To start with, let's just focus on the hash. Later on, we'll look at some other arithmetic approaches to this. But with the hash, what this means is that it will take the structure from the left. So the left is always the starting point when you start with the hash. And we can actually, we've already seen this actually with making an N pattern. We always put that first. So to make that pattern like this, because if we changed it round, put the sound here. Now we're only getting the kick, because on the left there's only one event, and so you only hear one event. If I put two CPUs here, then I'd also hear this, because this CPU is matching with the four halfway through this half, halfway through the cycle, rather. And if I put eight things, so with this hash, it takes what's on the left, starts with this structure, and then looks for values on the right that it can match with it. So that's something to bear in mind. With the N pattern, I often end up putting that first because it's normally the N pattern which I want the structure to come from. But with the others, it depends what you want to do. If you just want to change it all with a single value, then you could just put it on the right. But if you actually want to do a strange effect pattern, then you put it on the left like this. That's actually quite fun, isn't it? So I've got the CPU, everything is from this folder. Then I'm changing which sample it's picking from that folder, which sample number here. But that the structure isn't coming from that, it's actually coming from the squiz effect. So if I then took that, put it on the right. I've got an error somewhere. I've left a hash here. Yeah. There we go. So that's the basics of using the hash. The dollar, to start with, you might start getting confused between the dollar and the hash, especially a bit later this week when we start using functions. Think about the hash as always combining two patterns, whereas the dollar is just a way of taking everything to the right and treating it as a whole pattern to pass to the D1. So the dollar is like, all it does is take what's on the right and give it to the function on the left. The dollar has really low priority, which just makes that everything else on the right is worked out first. If it wasn't there, then it would get confused because it wouldn't know what pattern you want to send to D1. Looking at it, it's obvious to us, but a computer needs a bit more help. It needs us to put this here so that it knows that everything on the right is the pattern that we want to sequence and send to SuperDirt for turning into sound. Right, that's all I wanted to get through in this session. So have a look on at all the effects available and see how they sound with all the samples that you've like to use from the extra samples or the default samples or your own samples if you've started putting those in. And ask lots of questions and see you soon.